Most people have come across the idea of the Big Bang at one point or another, but does it really have any significance for everyday life? The discussion is really centered around one simple but very important question. Where did everything come from? It's interesting to study how the universe develops over time, but where did everything come from in the first place? What is the ultimate first cause? The implications are endless. Hugh Ross is an astronomer who will help us understand what some of the evidence is for the Big Bang. The Big Bang predicts an extremely hot early universe, which has been cooling ever since. Temperatures at various distances across the universe precisely match these predictions. This model also predicts that the initial hot conditions would have produced radiation everywhere we look in the universe. Scientists confirmed the existence of this radiation in 1964. Lastly, the Big Bang says that the universe is expanding. Now, light takes time to travel. As we receive the oldest light in the universe from the furthest reaches of space, we can see that the universe used to be more compact. All the science aside, the universe can only have one of three origins. It can be eternal, it can have a natural origin, or it can have a supernatural beginning. Let's take a look at the first option. Is the universe eternal? Dr. Frank Turek says, "Here's today, there's yesterday, there's the day before yesterday, there's last week. Question, can this line be infinite into the past? How could it be infinite into the past and today have arrived?" Logically speaking, this seems impossible, but what does the science have to say? The laws of thermodynamics state that energy can't be created or destroyed, and nature produces more entropy over time. Dr. Stephen Hawking says, "If your theory disagrees with the second law of thermodynamics, it is in bad trouble." In fact, the theory that the universe has existed forever is in serious difficulty with the second law of thermodynamics. So long as the universe had a beginning, we could suppose it had a creator. But if the universe is really self-contained, having no boundary or edge, it would have neither beginning nor end. It would simply be. What place then for a creator? Albert Einstein held to a similarly naturalistic worldview. It made him want the universe to be eternal, and therefore static, and he let this affect his equations. He assumed that as time goes on, the universe was sitting in place, largely unchanged. That was until Edwin Hubble showed Einstein evidence for the expanding, therefore finite, universe. In reality, as time marches forward, the universe expands. It's only reasonable to assume that as we back extrapolate further into the past, the universe must have been more compact, eventually reaching a point of near infinite density. Einstein let his presuppositions affect his math. He would go on to call this his biggest blunder. So, the universe can't be eternal. If it hasn't existed eternally, did it come from nothing? Or something, or someone? Could the universe have a purely natural origin? Hawking says, "All the evidence seems to indicate that the universe has not existed forever, but that it had a beginning about 15 billion years ago. This is probably the most remarkable discovery of modern cosmology, yet it is now taken for granted." Many people were unhappy with the idea that the universe had a beginning, because it seemed to imply the existence of a supernatural being who created the universe. Lawrence Krauss is a theoretical physicist and author of A Universe from Nothing. He says, "It can be truly said that we all are here today because of quantum fluctuations in what is essentially nothing." There you have it, a scientific explanation for the origin of the universe. But let's take a look at that one more time. What does he mean when he says essentially nothing? He goes on to say, "Something can arise from empty space precisely because of the energetics of empty space in the presence of gravity." He's using words like empty and nothing, but he's assuming the presence of energy, gravity, space, and quantum fluctuations. This is where we have got to think for ourselves. Are we really interested in the science, or are we just playing word games? Dr. Stephen Meyer points out, "Proponents of cosmology frequently claim the laws of physics explain the origin of the universe. This idea conceals an imprecision in thought and makes what philosophers call a category mistake. The laws of physics describe the interactions of things, matter and energy, that already exist within space and time. How could the laws have an effect before the material world even exists? Given the choices, is the supernatural option still really a stretch?" Dr. Vince Vitale says, "Criticism without alternative is empty." Option 1, God made it. Now, as a Christian, I might just put my hand up and say, wow, that is an incredibly extraordinary option. Alternative number 2, the universe just popped into existence from nothing for no reason whatsoever. The third alternative, maybe the universe has just always existed, extending infinitely back in time. You still have absolutely no explanation for why there is this enormous, intricate universe in the first place. I call it the normalcy of the supernatural. Alfer and Hermann calculate if the Big Bang model is correct, it will have produced a specific long wavelength radiation that will permeate the universe. Thus, the search began for the ultimate proof of the Big Bang creation model. Leads us to an unique event, a universe which was created out of nothing. The observations of modern science seem to suggest an underlying, one might say, supernatural plan. In the 21st century, we see the reverse of the God of the Gaps argument. Non-theists, confronted with problems when ample research leads to no natural explanations, and instead points to the supernatural, utterly reject this possibility of the supernatural, and insist on a natural explanation, even if it means resorting to absurdity. A astronomers now find they have painted themselves into a corner because they have proven by their own methods that the world began abruptly in an act of creation. They have found that all this happened as a product of forces they cannot hope to discover, that there are what I or anyone would call supernatural forces at work is now, I think, a scientifically proven fact.